Okay, so let's continue reviewing the Kinnick sum. And let's touch on what Andre and Maxime were... Oh, the other piece of homework was the word for Kinnick sum of Torah, wasn't it? Homework number two was, what is the word? Did I ask you for how many copies of the Torah?
For M.
In Torah. What is the word for the Kinnick sum within? Is it okay if I write in Torah what that means? It means that in is for any number in,
yeah.
You get Kinnick sum of that number. So for example, if in is 10, it means what is the word for Kinnick sum of 10 Torah?
I'm sorry, but you missed another in Torah, or is
in,
it written like that?
In Torah.
It's plural.
Torah. Yes, I know it's plural, but before I thought it was Torui.
No,
you.
Just, no, Torah.
Oh, okay.
Please ask if you're unsure. All right, okay, and so would anyone like to write down their formula for Andre? And Nicola, would you like to do the predictive plan for us next?
I didn't do the projective plan.
Yes, I did the projective plan.
Okay, so maybe Nicola,
so I can let Nicola
share.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it would be like A1, B1, 4.
A1 verse B1 verse, it is a sphere.
So just
no.
Here?
Yeah.
Just here? So it's, well, let's draw the picture.
No.
Nicola, please stay there. I'm just, I'm a piece of chalk. So let's draw it.
It's a torus.
A1, B1. A inverse, the A1. And then B1. Okay, so let's see, when we do this gluing, what do? We first form a cylinder.
Okay.
Just form a cylinder, and then we've got to glue. So that's gluing the A's. And then we've got the B's to glue. One, and when we do that, we get a...
Okay.
Thank you, please ask. So this part would be a word for a tortoise. And Nicola would like to share with us why you're going to show why the Kinnick sum of two Torah is that correct?
Okay, should I tell the example why it is so for two Torah?
Please.
Two? For two? Okay, explain. So, we would. Name this A, B, and B, A, and I name this C, D, C, D. Okay, we'll make a hole, and we'll get two pentagons. So that this each will be C, that D, that C, that D, and that I'll call F.
Is that another color?
Is everything right here?
Oh, looks right.
Okay, so now we'll glue E and F.
And Nikolai, could you draw an E and F in your top diagram? Just up here. Could you draw an E and F?
Okay. That's E. That's. Then we glue.
Не в ту сторону должно быть повернуто.
Yeah, you're right. Okay. That's B. That would be that's C. That's D. And that's C. And that's the voltage A and F. Okay? Is everything right on this board?
So, and so what is the word you get for that surface?
A, B, A, B, or A inverse, B inverse, D, C, D inverse, C inverse.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the best choice was to name D and C A2B2 and that A1B1,
mm-hmm.
But sorry for that. Okay. For I don't know how to say it in English, but пусть для N то ну то мы все доказали. For N Tori we have everything proved. And let's talk N plus one Tori.
Okay.
So. We got
good. Oh.
Yeah, induction.
You guys are familiar with inductions.
Oh. A2. The word of. Let's take the phi, the connexum of N Tori. A1B1, A2B2, and A. Oh.
Okay.
Yeah, I understood. Thank you.
So the induction step is assume that the connexum of N tori has the word. Is that what you're doing, Nikolai? You're going to assume this is true. And then Nikolai is then going to look at the connexum.
Of N plus 1 torque.
Of N plus 1 torque.
So we will took a Bloom diagram for the conic sum of N torque and we will make a hole again and the root will be
F.
There will be like C. And would made a hole in the torus which has left, and it will be a n plus 1, a n plus 1, b n plus 1, a n plus 1 inverse, b n plus 1 inverse, and d.
So this is the word for the
sum of n tori with a hole.
Mm-hmm. Good. And that is the word for?
The torus which has left with a hole. Okay? So we glue C and D. We took glue, and if you read starting from this point, the start point of n tori, A1, B1, we will read, and then we will, if we read, we will read A n plus 1, Bn plus 1, An plus 1 inverse, and Bn plus 1 inverse. That's actually the same as the four tutors, but that isn't a pentagon, it's something
polygon.
Ah, it's another polygon.
А сколько там будет ребер?
4n+1.
So we proved that for n plus 1 torus we'll get that word, and so the proof. I finished the proof. Are there any questions?
So, how many sides does the gluing diagram have?
You mean for all of them, or just for all of them?
Well, no, thank you, Nikolai. And what about the, and I think Andre is going to talk to us about the click sum of predictor planes. Daria, do you know what induction is?
Well, that section is a proof. So, one projective plane is A. Everybody can see that it's a projective plane. Yes? Понимаете, что это...
Понимают, конечно.
And if we make a cutout, we get a gluing diagram like this. So, and we'll call this. And glue them by these edges. We'll get this gluing diagram. And for n projective planes, if we want to add another one, we just make a cutout here. Yep. So let me write here. Yes. I just think it's pretty much obvious. A. And here we glue another projective plane. Like E. And we'll get a gluing diagram of A, C, C, E, E. And we can do that for each connect sum of n tori, the connect sum of n plus 1 tori, another projective plane, I'm sorry, will be the same word with an extra. So if we want a connect sum of n plus 1 projective plane, we just add A n plus 1, A plus 1. Is that clear?
Андрей.
One question.
Смотри, можем ли мы вырезать вот не на стыке А и С, а например, между цешками?
Мы как хотим, так вырезаем.
Да.
Да.
Вообще мы можем. Yes, we can.
Получится другое слово.
But, well, there can be multiple variants of that word. I just show you one of them.
Okay.
It, well, there wasn't a task to show all the words for that.
Nicholas, it's an issue. So this is actually a point. Nicholas pointed out this error. When I said what is that word, I really should have said what is a word.
Okay.
So that, thank you, Nicholas. There's no distinct words. You're saying we could cycle, we could relabel. But if we have one word, then that's all right. Okay, so that's a word for in predefined. And just to comment on what Andre was saying at the end here, was saying, if you connect some with a, if you take this thing, for example, and you connect some with a projective plane, it just means to replace this vertex with a two extra edges. Let's go. Z and Z. So that card becomes
3, 4, 5, 6.
So hit this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now it becomes a something with an extra side. That's it, eh? See, so when you keep on a rigid plane, just replace this vertex. Insert an extra pair of edges, so three new vertices, and two edges going this way. Is that what you're doing, Andre? And that's okay. So, and it's similar to what we do when we connect some to the sphere. So let me note that. Okay, so let's continue with the connect some. Let's do it by example firstly. So before you guys told me that the connect sum of a sphere and a sphere is a sphere, what is the connect sum of a torus with a sphere?
A torus.
Torus.
Now is that, do we see why that was? Because it's reviewed before. Well, let's, what if I said that was any surface, A? Some surface.
A.
Taking surface A and I connect some with a sphere.
A H S. Isn't A.
Any surface, a torus, climb bottle, break the plane.
Yeah.
That would be the same surface.
Claims it's also A. So let's see what that is. Because remember that the sphere, when we form the connect sum, we start with a sphere. We cut a hole. Cut a hole in the sphere.
Okay.
And we do the same for A. Whatever it's doing. Cut a hole. And so we get. Whatever A looks like, we know that when we cut, we look at one vertex, two edges, and we cut a hole, and so we get an extra edge. So whatever A is doing everywhere else, we know that we've got this edge here that we're gluing to the edge for the sphere. So that we get A, whatever happens outside there, but then we've got this A and this A. And we saw before that when we have an A and A inverse, that those two squeeze together and that these two edges are eliminated and we just have that one each again. Okay, so which is what we started off with A. We just end up with A again. Okay. Okay, so take your surface A, cut it a hole, and glue to the sphere minus the hole. But that sphere minus the hole, when you attach it on, it doesn't do anything. It doesn't do it. You return to what you started out with. Okay, so A with a, so any surface with some of the sphere is itself. Conversely, if we have some surface where we know that we've got an A and an A inverse, then we know that we can write it as something connects some with a sphere. Okay, so let's write that down. The surface has a word, it's called A, let's call it B, has a word with, so it's some word, but then somewhere we have a AA inverse. So for example, A, B, C, B, C, some word. If we have a inverse happening somewhere, it means that we have an edge, pair of edges like this. Okay? And we know that when we have a pair of edges like this, it means we've got some surface connects some with the sphere. So then B can be written as a some surface and a sphere. And this surface here, its gluing diagram, make this observation, the gluing diagram for the other piece must have fewer sides than the initial surface,
yeah,
because we eliminated two edges to get to A.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is kind of important when we think about induction later on. Okay. Which has a surface with two fewer edges. Let's look at the other thing we observed today about the projective plane. That's one. What about if the surface the word with a appearing, so e.g. if we have an a appearing, so that means that we have some gluing diagram, and we know we have AA to edges. What can we say about, let's say this is just B. What can we say about B?
It's A plus projective plane.
Yeah, some surface with a projective plane. Because remember that when we take a connect some with a projective plane, where we plonk on something like this, and we take our surface, we cut out a disc, and we get a gluing diagram with an extra edge. We take a projective plane, cut out a disc, and we get an extra edge. And then we glue those two edges together. And so we end up with a gluing diagram that looks like this. So it's just like the same thing with the sphere, except now the A's are going in the same direction. But then, so in this case, we know that B is the connection of A with a projective plane. And again, this has two fewer edges. And it's going over. And let me just ask, when we remove a pair of edges, these correspond to a pair of the same letter, AA or A. So that's useful. Okay, so now, the goal now is Let's continue to survey the results, and then we'll make a we'll speculate about what all the surfaces must look like. So far we know that A with anything with a sphere is a sphere. So e.g. a torus with a sphere is a torus.
Excuse me, why you are right as cut like
A.
Yeah.
Think. So for any surfaces. E.g. What else do we know? We know last time we looked at projector plane and the projector plane connects them. What does the projector plane connect them with the projector plane?
Climb bottle.
That was the climb bottle. So remember that the climb bottle, we've proved before that the climb bottle has this word, A, B. So in particular, the climb bottle is connects on the projector plane.